Okay, so let's start, and we are going to do the leaves. And instead of hand modeling them in ZBrush or in 3ds Max, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a certain website and I'm going to check texture.com. It's a really great website with a bunch of 3D textures. And what I'm really interested in is especially the 3D scans. And if I type, for example, IV into the search bar, you can see here and here, for example, they have a bunch of scan texture which are really handy. And we are going to start from those one. You could do, if you want, you could start by modeling them and sculpting them. The really good thing with Houdini is that you don't have to replace all of your workflow with Houdini. You can just start just using a bit of Houdini in the middle. But here we are just going to start with those textures. Actually, I'm going to take those one. I'm going to download all of them, but the one I'm really interested in are the albedo, the normal map. I think I'll take the roughness too, and the opacity map. So let's just download all the texture and I will see you just after that. Okay, now we are in Houdini and we just downloaded the texture. Let me show you them. So I have the albedo, the opacity and the normal map. I downloaded the other one too. This one is the roughness and this one is the translucency, but I'm not even sure I'm going to use them anyway. So here we are in Houdini. This should be the, you know, the standard interface, and I'm using Houdini 16.5. I advise you to use 16.5 minimum. It should work below, but we never know. First of all, let me remove some of the things away so we have a bit more space. I'm going to collapse these parameters, and I like to have another one just vertical. That way it's just easier for me to work. So this one will be parameters. So I have my network view here, my scene view to the left, and my parameters to the right. And don't forget to save your file. First thing first, we are going to load the texture. For that, we are going to use the trace node. So if I just create a geometry, let me right now call this IV2. Okay. And here I'm going to delete this and use the trace node. So the trace node, honestly, it's not a node I use a lot, but it can be really, really handy, honestly. So the trace node, what it allows you to do is it will take a bitmap and it will try to create a geometry out of this. The example one is a circle. So you can see it's generating just, a circle. And if I click on the, you know, this button to load my pictures, let me show the pictures. I want to load this one, the opacity. Let's load it. And then, you know, already it's, I think it's pretty magical. Like if I show the points, there is a lot of points, but since the original texture is already pretty clean, the result the trace node gives us, it's really clean. Doing this in 3ds Max or in other modeling software will take already a lot of time, but this is really good. We also have a threshold here. Honestly, I won't use it. 0.5 was already perfect for us, and we just want to get this done really fast. We don't need to tweak the every parameter a lot. We just want to have some leaves really quickly. First thing, as you saw, there is a lot of point, maybe a bit too much. So what we are going to do, use a resample. It will allow us to remove a bunch of point, not that much of course, but if we play with the length parameter, we can choose how much we want. I'm going to go slowly. I want still to keep, you know, quite some point because it's supposed to be high poly. Something like this is pretty good. Okay. Oh, and right now I'm going to say this. You will see me go really fast in the node network to display and disable some node. I'm using two shortcuts. The one is Q. If you hold Q and you hit a node, it will toggle the display, the bypass flag, sorry. So it's really handy, you can just select a bunch of them. And the R key is the same for the display flag. So here, if I just select R and like this, it's really easy instead of going there and clicking. So I will just explain this one so you understand why I'm going all over the place with my selection like this. So this is good enough for us. What we want now is some topology inside of the leaf, because right now it's just flat. So let's do that right now. We are going to use the remesh. The remesh will do exactly what say, it will remesh a shape and actually create some topology. Let's just be careful with it because it depends on the scale of your scene. So if you have a value too little, this one is a target edge length. So the smaller the value, the smaller triangles you will have. So you can get crazy high numbers, so be careful with that one. Let's start with, 0.2 give us pretty large triangle, which we don't want. But we are going to lower this value little by little. Let's try 0.1. Still too high because nothing changed. Let's try half of that. Okay, we are starting to see some stuff. Even half of that. Not half, of course. 0.1 is pretty good. Let's go even lower. 0.05. Yeah, this is pretty good for us. So now we have some kind of topology we can start to work around. In ZBrush, usually at this point you will start sculpting, but we don't want to do that. We are going to try to use some of these textures to generate some of the details for us. What we want to do is to load the texture. What I want to load is a normal map, but if I want to apply a texture on a mesh directly in SOP, what I need to use is to use the attribute from map, this one. The only issue is that it uses UVs. So if I walk, no. This is like a checker texture it's using, but there is no UVs. A quick way to see the UVs, if you hit space and 5, with a mouse above the viewport, you can see the UVs. And if I hit space 1, I go back to the geometry, so space 5. And here you can see I have no UVs. So let's put this one right here for now. And I'm going to use a UV project. And if I plug it, look. Oh yeah, I have perfect UVs. What it's doing is just doing a projection on the, I think by default it's going to use a the XY plane, which is perfect for me. And I don't want even to touch initialize or anything because I don't want it to scale or move my UVs, because right now they are pretty much matching perfectly this thing. You know, the layout of the leaves are the same that in 3D, which is what I want. So now if I use the attribute from map, already you can see, you know, we have some UVs. And let's load the normal map. Okay, it's a bit dark. Let me put just a constant material. This way I can see better. And you see, it's pretty much a perfect match. Now the second step is I want to isolate the blue channel. You know, this channel. So if I can get this information onto Houdini, I can push the point with those black and white value. And let's do this right now. Let me just rearrange this. And let's try to organize stuff just a bit. We'll call this leaf maker. Let's put a nice color here. Give us some space. Okay, like this is good. So we want to isolate the blue color of the normal map. We could use Wrangle. Let's go with the point sub. This one, which is a bit confusing at first, but I think yeah, it's good practice to use it. If you never use it, I'm just going to explain it really quickly. Here, first thing you have to do is to say on which attribute you want to work. Do you want to work with the position, the color, the alpha, etc.? All of this still on the point context, of course. And then the expression is the actual value you are going to set. So let's say I want to work on color. By default, it's written self. And self is just meaning, okay, keep your previous value. If I set an arbitrary value like red, you know, it's overriding the previous color and using the color I set. And if here I put the keyword value, it enables me to access this area and I can just mess around with the value. But if the value keyword is not here, this area is grayed out. What I can do is do stuff like, okay, self multiplied by value. No. And now I'm just multiplying the current color by some value. There is multiple way to extract the blue channel. I'm going to do, let's think, so I'm going to start with self. I'm going to multiply it with a new vector, which is going to be 0, 0, 1. That way everything is cancelled but the blue value. And you know what, actually, even faster than this, let's do @cd to access the color. Let's do b. So it's a quick and dirty way, but yeah, it should work. It's pretty hard to see because it's really blown out. Let's fake a bit of the level adjustment I did in Photoshop by doing a power. So I think pow, and let's add 10, maybe 50. Let's see with 50. Okay, pretty good, and that's perfect for us. So let's say isolate blue. And then we will put down another points node, and we call this displacement with a typo. So now we have this node. We are going to, let's take the white value and push them along the Z axis. So self, we need to keep self because we need to keep the original value, and we want to add something. So let's add, so set to create a new vector. So for now, let's add nothing. And let's add, if I do chf and push, this is going if I click this button, it's going to create me a value. And now, like a slider linked to this. And if I change this, it should, yeah, no, change only on the Z axis. And then let's modulate this with, let's use @cd.air, for example. So I'm just taking one channel of the color. Let's try this. Hey, it's working. And I'm just going to put down a color node so I can see what I'm doing. And let's do this. Looks pretty good for me. It's more than enough, honestly. Don't worry too much about how good it looks. We are going to, let's extrude this so it have some kind of thickness. Let's go output back and let's try the other way. Let's go really slowly, something like this. You know what, let's use the power of Houdini. Let's try to put the poly extrude above what we did. Maybe the other way around. Yeah, like this looks good. Let's also add a subdivision in the middle with this thing, so we put the division to 2. And let's smooth everything, and how it looks, pretty good. Maybe the smooth is a bit too hard. Yeah, I think that's good enough. Honestly, we don't have to spend much more time on those. Anyway, we are also going to do a poly reduce because we are going to duplicate a lot of those leaves. So if they are too high poly, it's going to be hard to keep performance to a reasonable level. So let's go 20. Yeah, that's pretty good for me. So without, we are going to create a null. I'm going to call this out leaves. So this is only what we needed to do the leaf. Doing that in a max is really long. I'm pretty sure if you already done it, you can already see the benefits of using Houdini for something like this. Now that we have this, I'm going to export the leaves and place them correctly in 3ds Max. That way the pivot for each leaf is rightly connected. And see you in the next video.